Looking to turn some old cards into new fetch lands? Check out channelfireball.com's online buy list. We've got ferociously competitive prices on cards new and old, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you'd prefer to pick up singles, boosters, or even a battle box, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to channelfireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order, and soon you'll be rolling in villainous wealth.
Yo, TWoo here. Shout out, much love to all viewers from wherever you're from. Here at channelfireball.com. Very, very fun series today as we do a deck building exercise, which I think is really important, and construct a monster competitive deck, which is, I think, it's just very fun. Y'all will see. So, to start off, we're playing with Relentless Rats. You can play any number of these, and they're 3 mana 2/2. For each Relentless Rats, it gets +1/+1. So 1 is a 2/2. 2 is a 3/3. 3 is 3 4/4s. 4 is 4 5/5s for 3 mana, so that is quite a rate. Especially for an uncommon, is pretty good. So, how many can you play? As many as possible. Throw in 36. Throw in Thrumming Stone. Make it a deck. Well, if we look at the curve here, we have 24 lands, 36 rats. What's our turn 1 plan? Swamp. What's our turn 2 plan? Swamp. Turn 3 we can play Relentless Rats. Turn 4 we can play Relentless Rats. Turn 5 we can play 1 Relentless Rats. Turn 6 finally we can do 2 things, but still just play 2 Relentless Rats. It's not competitive, and I want to be competitive with Relentless Rats. And just by cost sorting the deck and looking at what's our plan against turn 1 Goblin Guide Scoop, right, what's our plan against turn 1 anything, right, we can see that, okay, we can cut some number of Relentless Rats, fill the deck with 1 and 2 drops, give us some things to do on turn 4 or turn 5. So this is a cost sorting exercise. If you do not cost sort your deck, this is the very first and simplest thing you can do to improve your deck building. Cost sorting reveals holes in game plans. Magic the Gathering is played turn by turn, so we want to know what our game plan is turn by turn. So with this deck, our game plan is Thoughtseize, Inquisition to disrupt the opponent, some destructive elements out the gate, Aether Vial to start ramping. Second turn, we can Ravenous Rats to continue attacking the opponent's hand, few pieces of removal spell, Pack Rat to get going. Pack Rat is great. Gives us lots of options in the late game, protects us from Flood. And then we have 16 Relentless Rats, which is, or 15, which is 1 in 4. So we're going to expect to start with about 2 and draw into our 3rd and 4th for 3 mana 5/5s. This deck I'm also playing 4 Swarm Yard and 4 Mutavaults, which is a lot to go with. Bunch of lands, Urborgs, to make these into black producing lands, but for we know the power of Mutavault. This thing is great for pumping Pack Rat, but maybe more importantly, gives us things to do on the fifth turn. We play Relentless Rats and 2 mana up for Mutavault. Even better is Swarm Yard. This card is crazy. Tap to regenerate a rat, tap to regenerate a creature. It's crazy overpowered in this deck. Protects. Only 1 mana to use, so it gives us things to do on turn 4. Turn 2 to protect with Vial. Speaking of Vial, this thing just curves tremendously. By turn 4, we can start playing 2 Relentless Rats a turn, which is way ahead of the other build. So this is the build. It's just Relentless Rats on a curve is all it is. Take a Relentless Rats deck, give it things to do turn 1, turn 2, turn 4, turn 5. Some ways to alleviate Flood, some destructive elements, some other options. And what we have is, you will see in the games, but this deck is competitive. It's curved, it curves out, and it is pretty interactive as well. So it's a nice one. Mutavault and Swarm Yard really showing their power. Dip into the sideboard, not so important for this exercise. Looks like I only have 13 cards, which doesn't sound right. It seems like I had 15 at some point. But talk about cards that I'm playing. Yeah, I don't know what some cards got lost somewhere. Leyline of the Void to shut down graveyard decks. A little bit of extra removal. Discard removal. Typhoid Rats is a and when we need extra early drops. And this thing with Swarm Yard regeneration is pretty crazy at holding down the fort. And that's basically the deck. Really simple, streamlined, fun, aggressive. I hope this helps you in your deck building endeavors, and I hope that some of you are inspired to even build this deck. Let's get to the matches and see how it plays out. It's going to be fun, so make sure you tune in for those. Peace. Yo, we're up against M. Hayashi, and we're TWoo here with the Mono Black Relentless Rats brew, and my favorite start ever of turn one Ether Vial. We have. So, played against M. Hayashi previously with the Active Bees deck, and Dismember is more life than we want to pay. So this could be tough. It could definitely be tough. A lot of life to lose. Ravenous Rats is pretty great in this matchup, actually. Hopefully we draw a land so we can get some action into play. Maybe use Dismember. I'm just going to not use Dismember. Get a second Vial down. Take our Lumps this turn. And then we can start to take over with Rats in the next turn. Ravenous Rats to drain the opponent's hand. Lava Spike. Taking a beating. I mean, we are definitely taking a beating. See if we're down to 8. Another Grim Lavamancer. Okay, well, take the last card from the opponent's hand. Opponent's so fast that the Ravenous Rats are not even doing so much. Draw another Swamp. I'm choosing to play the Pack Rat, Searing Blaze. So, playing the Pack, playing Ravenous Rats, then waiting for the opponent's draw to Ravenous Rats again probably would have been better. But now that we're in this position, throwing out another Ravenous Rats right now feels like a waste. Could hold up and pay 2 life with Dismember. I'm going to play the Pack Rat. Don't think I played this turn very well, to be honest. I think that the optimal play would have been tap 2 for Ravenous Rats, go to the draw step, throw out another Ravenous Rat. Because this is going to result in us losing this Pack Rat, which otherwise would be important in bolstering our team, but after having all, sometimes you make a mistake and you have to readjust your plan, and that mistake was tapping the Ether Vial immediately. But we can make up for it on this next turn. I'm gonna choose to take the hit, not to chump block just yet. Definitely not over at 7 life. Tick up to 3, tick up to 2. We can upkeep, pinch a card from the opponent's hand, hoping to draw a Swarm Yard, actually. We have the Dismember available as well. Pass the turn. In the draw step. Hope the opponent's drawn a sorcery or a creature. Something that we can get value from off this Ravenous Rat. We did. Sweet. Gonna double block with Ravenous Rats. If the opponent wants to Grim Lavamancer, then that's okay. We can let our rats die. Keep Dismember in hand for a moment. Play Relentless Rat, untap and add 2 more Relentless Rats to the board. Alternatively, we could Dismember that Monastery Swift Spear. But that would mean it would give the opponent a second creature or a second card in their graveyard to use for Grim Lavamancer, which we don't want to do. So now we, the Relentless Rats parade begins. I'm just doing this now in case I accidentally say yes. Use this ability, no. Use this ability, yes. Draw for the turn. Swamp's not so bad because it means we can use Dismember without taking damage. And at this point, beat down the opponent. Save this Dismember. Don't really want to give the opponent more Grim Lavamancer fuel. So we're in a decent position, actually. It's definitely a house of cards that can crumble based on the opponent doing things. Use this ability. No. Use this ability. No. Mutavault's not a bad draw. We can't do so much with it right now, but it's not a bad one. Since we have a non-lethal attack this turn anyways, we're going to send with only one Relentless Rat. Sending with two could maybe work. See how the opponent chooses to block here. We have Dismember available to break up shenanigans. Click OK. So we could let this resolve. Right now, we should kill this Grim Lavamancer. It's a tough call. We could, if we kill this Grim Lavamancer, yeah, that seems like what we should do. Because if we wait, the opponent's gonna be able to. So if we wait, the opponent's gonna get more food in their graveyard, which, and be able to actually use that Grim Lavamancer. Although, if they say they play a burn, they could, we'll be able to use, it's really awkward. I'm having a hard time wrapping my head around this. If we just let this resolve, then either way, the opponent's going to be able to use Grim Lavamancer, so I'm just going to click OK. And then respond to the opponent with this Dismember. Seems better this way. Okay, so we traded. The opponent can shouldn't be able to crumble everything. They can Lavamancer one. Is that targeting us? Putting us to 5. Definitely want to kill that thing right away. So maybe we get burned out. I think the opponent's going to have to top deck to do it. And we have 14 coming. So we're in position to win depending on the opponent's top decks. This turn we're going to go for 14. Maybe the opponent has a Searing Blaze and can buy another turn and victory out of that. But Relentless Rats off the top is a good draw. Attack with all. Because it's extra damage in combat coming in. So if the opponent goes to burn our Mutavault, 4, 8, 12. This is 14 right now, so I'm not going to play Rats unless necessary. Bam, got there. Go to sideboarding. So I feel like Swarm Yard is just our best card here. Against Burn, it's crazy. Thoughtseize is fine. Inquisition is better. I probably don't actually want Dark Blast. Gonna cut the Dismember for a Doomblade. Dark Blast only kills Grim Lavamancer. Then Typhoid Rats seems good. And Liliana seems good. Typhoid Rat seems okay. I don't think we want Liliana because we still want as many Relentless Rats as we can play. Liliana is decent, but just, it's, she's actually a bit slow. So then the last decision is whether we want typhoid rats over maybe ravenous rats or pack rats or Thoughtseize. I'm not in love with Thoughtseize. It's fine. I don't hate it. Play one. It gains a life because we take something that deals three or more. I don't want the Dark Blast just because if they don't draw Law of Mancer, it does nothing. Thoughtseize will always do something. It's not a great top deck card, but I don't mind. I actually don't mind it against Burn. This is a pretty good one. I mean, it'd be a lot better on the play, but we did win the first game, so don't get that luxury. We have no other vials. We don't even have two other vials this game. If the opponent has no turn one play, that's great for us, because if they don't have creatures, it could be tough for them to win. We'll have time for the Ravenous Rats to extract value. Hopefully draw Swarm Yard to protect our team. Lightning Bolt. Probably wasn't going to take that anyway. Three Atarka's commands. It's just so clunky that we might as well take the Lightning Bolt. So, sure. Opponent has three Atarka's commands. Probably should read that. Not exactly sure what the modes do. Pumps the team. Can't gain life. 3 damage, etc., etc. Start off with pressuring with Ravenous Rats. Pass the turn. Yeah, this Rats deck is out of this world. It's definitely the truth. Okay, Atarka's Command. What did the opponent discard? A land. Swarm Yard. That's an insane one. Yeah, Swarm Yard is insane. I think this deck is actually very good. Which is great, because it's just rat-tastic. I'm gonna go with an Inquisition and a Ravenous Rat. So leave the opponent with nothing. Target's Command. Gonna hide the Swarm Yard just for a turn, so we can untap and play Relentless Rats with Swarm Yard up. Opponent down to just that one card now. One Atarka's Command, which they're going to hang on to. Creature in play. Swarm Yard. Relentless Rats with Swarm Yard up. We could throw down the Typhoid Rats, because we know the opponent doesn't have Burn, and even if they do, whatever. But, played against this player previously, they had Earthquake, so Earthquake is a thing that we might need to play around, which I am willing to do. Yeah, it feels like we're about to wrap this matchup. Thoughtseize, not going to play that. We'll play another Relentless Rats, though. Attack for 4. Swarm Yard up. 6, 7, 8 coming next turn to put the opponent to 1. At 4 life. Pretty safe. 6. Oh, we have 8 coming and the opponent's at 8. Drawing for the turn. Other vial. Attack. Attack with all. See if the opponent can break this up. Swarm Yard. I'm gonna regenerate. Generate target rat. Opponent takes 5. Even if they have Earthquake, they're dying, so ship the turn, hang on to the Typhoid Rats and the Thoughtseize. Yeah, so even if they have the Earthquake at this point, that's game. Bam, did it. Sweet.